Yes, is there anyone in this room who feels it's not important to have a positive attitude?
No.
I hardly find that surprising. Mr. Secretary, of fellow Toastmasters and Pyle in particular, you have addressed the first of the objectives of the project, which says appeal to the audience interest. And I thought you hit the nail on the head because all of us are interested in having a positive attitude. Well done. Topic selection was apt. Second part of the project says a balance of logic and emotional appeal. Emotional appeal, I thought that was one of your strengths. Dr. Rajdeep's story, very emotional, touching. Your personal story where you failed in that contest. So emotional appeal is very high, one of your strengths. Now, moving on to suggestions, if I may. The logical appeal. I thought here we could perhaps give a little more information to persuade the audience to have a positive attitude. If I were in your place, I would share this example. Just consider this. There was a gentleman who, at the age maybe in his 60s, mid-60s, was jobless, homeless, cold, hungry, and he didn't know what to do. All he had was a chicken recipe. And he went to more than hundreds of places asking people to buy his recipe. No one obliged. He did not give him. He could not give up because of his positive attitude. And a little later, he started his own restaurant across 6 continents, 100 countries. I guess you know what I'm talking about. Colonel Sanders of KFC fame. So that's, you know, that logical appeal. You said 1% was 90%. You gave us logic there. 1% is what happens to you, right?
Yeah. 1%
is how you,
what life gives you. 99% how we respond.
So you could just give an example, that logical example. This project also says that you have to persuade the audience to take some action. Generally, I got the feeling by informing us the importance of having good attitude. You know, what lies inside is important, not what behind, what, you know, you're informing us. If I were in your place at the end of the presentation, I would have made that call to action. Now friends, you heard about Rajdeep, he succeeded. Colonel Sanders, he succeeded in setting up KFC. Now they can do it. You and I can do it by having a positive attitude. Right from today, always have a positive attitude. That call to action was missing. There's more information I thought. Third suggestion. This project says the organizing technique, there are 3-4, you opted for the proposition to prove. That means every point that you give, that you have to give us a supporting, you have to substantiate. You did for Rajdeep's case, your story, the balloon vendor, very nice. You also told about happy people, unhappy people. There, if I were in your place, approve. There was one person who was very happy and was a positive attitude, his happiness, he rewrote history books with regard to cricket. And one unhappy guy in the same city, lot of talent, but he was nowhere. Well, I'm talking about, yes.
You know, Dumbly and
Sachin, thank you. Yeah, so the happy guy was Sachin. Proposition to prove. Having said that, why? The positives. This project says good body language, which you did demonstrate. Vocal variety was good. You used the stage very well. And no notes. You were conference personified. I've heard you say that you want to be a motivation speaker, and motivation speakers must be persuasive. So, Pyle, you're well and truly on the way of being a wonderful motivation speaker. It's back to the G.